Acer SB230 and SB270 Ultra Thin Zero Frame Monitor. The SB230 and SB270 are identical in all ways except one. Their names give it away. The SB270 is a 27 inches monitor, while the SB230 is a 23 inches monitor. Because one is larger than the other, the smaller weighs 8 pounds, while the larger weighs 11 pounds. That's really the entire difference between them. Even though these are entry-level monitors, both the SB230 and SB270 have a handful of mid-range features. Features like FreeSync, and greater than standard refresh rates. And that makes both of these panels pretty respectable, especially relative to their approachable cost. Build and design. Both the SB230 and SB270 use a very standard, very minimalistic bezel. Once again, this is heavily implied in their name, Ultra Thin Zero Frame Monitor. Each is nearly as thin as the bezel Acer uses on their top-shelf Predator monitors. Viewed from an angle, these panels are devastatingly thin. It makes them terribly stylish, though also a little bit more fragile while you're moving them. Connectivity. On the back side of each monitor, you'll find one HDMI port, one VGA port, and one 3.5mm audio jack. It might be worth noting there's no DVI input, or DisplayPort input. Though that shouldn't be a huge issue because neither of these panels require features or bandwidth unique to those formats. You're not going to be running 4K through these 1080p panels, after all. Dynamic Sync. Both the SB230 and the SB270 feature AMD Radeon FreeSync, a dynamic sync technology. When enabled, the general idea is that your monitor will change its refresh rate to match the FPS output of your graphics card. This can prevent screen tearing, and more importantly, keep your games running smooth. Video quality. Both panels use 1920x1080 resolution, more commonly known as Full HD. But that doesn't mean that both monitors look the same. That's because there are differences in pixel density. The larger 27 inches monitor has lower pixel density, while the smaller 23 inches monitor has a greater pixel density. For the typical kind of distances that people sit from their monitors, the difference will be noticeable. Refresh rates. Monitors work by flashing an image at you, called a frame. These frames are shown, one after another, to create the illusion of motion. For the past two decades, a refresh rate of 60 Hz was fairly standard for nearly every PC monitor. That indicates a monitor is capable of displaying 60 frames per second. IPS panel problems. The SB230 and the SB270 are both IPS panels, capable of providing exceptionally rich colors and superior viewing angles over TN panels. For all their strengths, IPS panels do have their faults. Perhaps most noteworthy, IPS panels are capable of suffering from backlight bleeding. In fact, virtually all IPS panels will have a small amount of backlight bleeding. Other considerations. If you're interested in gaming, and you're willing to spend a bit more, it's worth considering a 144Hz in place of the 75Hz these panels provide. But you would also need a PC that can churn out higher frame rates. Acer monitors like the SB230 and SB270 include a 3-year warranty. It's not very common for monitors to have problems that require the use of a warranty, but it's nice to be protected. Acer also has a reputation for reasonably good customer support. Who should choose Acer SB230 and SB270 Ultra Thin Zero Frame Monitor? Both of these monitors were made for people on a tight budget. The SB230 is a good choice for someone who's sitting very close to their monitor, and someone with significant space limitations. Though 23 inches is a little small for the tastes of some people, the SB230 is definitely the best-looking version in this series. It has all the power of the SB270, and it's about one-third less expensive. The SB270 is a good choice for someone who wants the biggest 1080p display they can get their hands on. If you wanted to move to a 32 inches panel, you'd also want to upgrade to 1440p. But gaining those extra 5 inches is terribly expensive. You would basically need to double your budget.